Hi everybody, I'm Marina and welcome to my Ceramics Oasis channel. Today I will tell you how to build this decorative set, vase and plate. And for this project we're going to use Aurora air dry clay and I will mix it with grounded coffee for texture. Let's start. Aurora clay is my favorite air dry clay. It has beautiful light gray color and it's very strong after drying. So you can use it for sculpture and you can use it for decorative pottery. I'm going to use half of this bag. It's probably about 2 pounds. And please keep your bag closed every time because it will dry very, very fast. Flat it. I will mix it with grounded coffee and I will get this beautiful texture. Coffee. I wait it until my color will be uniform. There's beautiful coffee smell around. You can enjoy. I can add more. Of course, it will depend on your taste. If you like it's more dark, you can add more coffee. More texture, more coffee. And I can stop. I like this color. I divide my clay on 2 parts. I'm going to use small one for plate and big piece for vase. Here's my pattern. You can see. And I check, will my pattern fit to this size? Yes, so I can start working on slab. Let's check. Yes, now I can cut it. You can do free cutting or if you're not sure in your hands, you can use ruler. Place your ruler next to your slab and cut. Okay. Next step, I have to smooth all these edges. Use container with water and sponge. I'm going to make few holes, so I will start from holes now. I'm going to use this tiny cup and I will trace it first. Might be here and trace it again. Okay, now I can use knife and cut. Keep your blade clean. Again, use sponge. You will need a piece of plastic. I use plate and seal, but you can use any thin plastic. Put it here. And flip your slab. Again, I'm going to smooth the surface again around and the circles. Now I'm going to connect it. Put it around and overlap here. Let's score. Add water and connect second part. Okay. Okay, from this moment I will need bending wheel. And I place paper on the bending wheel. Place it here. Press. Make strong connection. You can use a rice spoon, flat it. Also use sponge. Check circle here and check circle on the bottom. Okay. Now we can add few waves. I use graffiti tool and just freehanding. And I'm going to connect these two parts, lines together. Like this. And here. Oops, I can fix it. Little mistake. Okay, if you need to fix it, you can use metallic grip and just smooth it. My goal was connect this line around the circle. Okay. You can use shaper or you can use brush, backside of your brush, and just follow your line again. Again, dip my sponge in the water and follow this line. Next step, we have to build bottom, and I'm going to use scratch clay. Place your slab on bending wheel and place your vase here. Trace first. And please leave extra tiny, tiny space. Make this circle slightly bigger than diameter of your vase, because you will overlap it. Okay, now I can cut it. I will use a rice spoon. And I will overlap. Also push slightly to the bottom and flip it. Now we will start build plate or bowl. For this part you will need any round bowl and you will need piece of plastic. Let's start from slab. Because it's set, I will repeat similar decoration for my bowl. And I like to keep it slightly irregular, more biomorphic. Again, do not forget about sponge. Might be few holes. Sponge again. Place this plastic. Flip it. Sponge again. And I'm going to repeat pattern. Might be wave like this. Use shaper. And sponge. And I just want to press this tiny cup to add extra circle for decoration. One here and might be one here. Sponge. Next step, you have to move your plate, your slab, to your bowl. Be very careful. Do not push. And I notice that this slab does not fit to this plate, so I will change my plate and use another one, more shallow. Okay, let's try. Yeah, much better. Can you see? I'm working very, very gentle. And you don't need to reach button. Just make it round. But not very, very deep. So I finish these two parts of my set. And I will let them dry for 2 or 3 days. After it, guys, I will tell you how to decorate it using acrylic paints, metallic gold, and very concentrated coffee. See you soon. Bye-bye. Hi again. And we start working on this project last time. And we built vase and little plate. And it's dry today, so I can start paint it. And for this project, we're going to use very unusual paint. It's coffee. 3 cups of espresso coffee plus I evaporate water, so it's very, very concentrated color. Plus I will use dark, dark acrylic, like born amber. And I will use golden color Martha Stewart liquid gold. If you do not have liquid gold, you can use any metallic acrylic paints. Let's start. I will start my decoration from coffee. And I add first layer. And you can add 2, 3, or 4 layers. Depends what color would you like to reach.
If you would like to keep it light, I think one layer will be enough. But I would like to keep it in medium tone, so I will apply 3 layers. Okay, I will let it dry and I will start working with my vase. I hold it like that and add color. Do not forget to add it for this rim. Be careful and be accurate. Okay, let it dry. And now I can work with my plate. Okay, switch again. You can see how wet coffee can move around. It creates very beautiful texture. Let it dry and switch again. It's my third layer. To avoid dripping, I just turn it upside down. I just love this natural pattern. If it's dry too slow, you can use hair dryer. Okay, here is 3 layers and I would like to add couple more. I really admire this texture. And I can move my coffee back and forth. You can see I turn my vase, create like rust texture. When I work on my projects, I love a combination of different techniques, like natural surface plus something flat like acrylic and might be metallic color. And see, I can move coffee around this area. So now we're working wet to wet. You can see like color move down. I will turn my project. And now I can use hair dryer again. And my last layer, fix. Now I can start using my hair dryer again. Okay, 2 more layers for plate. And I love to play with liquid coffee. See, I move it around this area and it looks like rust texture now. Like metallic rust. Let's dry it. If you make tiny mistake, it's very easy to fix. Just use wet brush and clean this area. I would like to add coffee also for the circle. What I love about this technique, every time when you add coffee, it looks different. So my first one looks like more rusty. This more flat, but it's okay. I love it. Okay, next we're going to use acrylic paint, very very dark one. It's born amber. And for this color, we're going to use stencil. We're going to use tape. It's masking tape. And I add it to my project. Okay, now I can use brush and acrylic, and I'm going to overlap my tape. Overpaint it. And you can notice these two colors have same hue, right? But different texture. It's flat, and this one has texture. And slightly lighter. I think two layers will be enough. And also I will paint bottom. I work directly from tube. I do not mix it with water. Now I can remove my tape, be very, very accurate. And you will get beautiful straight line. Okay, let it dry. For this plate, I will attach, try to avoid kissing edges when two lines connect each other. Let's overlap slightly. Okay. And also I'm going to paint inside of this circle. Okay. Let's remove this tape. And here between. And I notice right now it will be good idea to add coffee here. Okay, so my paints are dried now. And I'm going outside to spray it with sealer. And let me show you three different sealers. It's matte, gloss, and satin. I'm going to use satin for this project, but it also depends on your taste. See you in 30 minutes. I sprayed my project with spray sealer. And now it's dry. Just would like to remind you guys, do not forget to use mask when you use sealer. Now I'm going to use metallic Martha Stewart gold, liquid gold. And you should spray it first, and only after it you should add gold. Do not use expensive brushes, cheap one. And I'm not going to wash it after. Just throw away. It looks like a golden luster for ceramics. Very, very natural. And I want to add few tiny circles, golden circles. might be tiny here. And I think I can add metallic cream around. Okay. Let it dry. And I will finish my vase. For vase, I'm going to color this area and might be add few circles. Okay, I'm going to paint this rim also. Might be overlap golden color a little bit. Okay, and I'm going to add few golden circles. Might be one here. And for balance, one here. Okay. I think that's it. No more gold. So I finished my set. And I will let it dry for a few minutes. After it, I can use it like a holder for candy or for cookie or for nuts. And also, I can use this vase for dry plants arrangement. And guys, thank you for your attention and see you next week.